This is Full Game Prometheus giving you another full gameplay for you guys to see. We're using 34 on defense, 34 odd, and then on offense, I'm doing a custom playbook, custom scheme from one of my Patreon members. So you're going to see kind of a slight variation of what I normally do with these full gameplays. Generally, I will show you the play art, but because of my Patreon requesting that I show him gameplay and have it a completely private scheme, basically you won't see any kind of play art with this. Nor am I going to disclose what playbook this is out of. I just want to kind of show you sometimes making reads and making certain type of regressions. This game, I will share with you, got ugly really, really quick against my opponent. He no huddles here. I get a big 16-yard sack. I jump into man pressure against this guy. He's in that pistol bunch set that's been so popular and so meta for many years, and he actually hits me up. He cues me up with the perfect play against my man coverage and actually takes it down to get an easy touchdown right there with the first possession. So it's not a really good way to start the game. I do a little outside run right there, try to go back to an option run. You're going to see me try this a couple more times. It didn't really work too successful for me. And then a third down situation, he actually goes ahead and gets a nice little user sack right there. Puts me in 4th-and-21 type of situation, and I force a pass and actually give the ball back to him in field goal range. So that's really not that smart of a move right there. I shouldn't have given the ball back to him, but I think I was just a little bit frustrated with the series of plays that were going down right there. So right here, set up some kind of pressure. And I think I actually got guys down. No pressure right there. I just showed him a look. But he takes off with the Drew Brees. He's able to pick up a good 10-yard or 12-yard gainer with the quarterback. So this guy showed patience. He's actually played. He showed patience with letting a play break down. He knows how to beat man coverages. So this guy actually has an offensive scheme, and he knows what to do. And you'll see him using a lot of the same formations. No huddles out of this I-form formation. And I actually set up some type of pressure right there. He takes off this quarterback. I go and click the spy down and actually go ahead and bottle him up. And an intelligent player takes his points. So going up 10-0 is better than going just being up 7. He takes his points and penalizes me for not adjusting. So hit him with a little deep out route right here because I was seeing the off coverage. Go back to the stretch play. He gets some pretty good blocking, but he couldn't get past that one defender. So I only pick up a few yards. Come back to this play right here. I get picked off. Down 10-0. He gets a really good animation with Lattimore and takes it into the end zone. So I'm down 17-0. I'm sure that a lot of you guys are being a situation like this, down 17-0. You'd quit out and just start a new game. But I'm trying a new scheme out. This is a Patreon scheme, and I want to see if I can actually get back into it against my opponent. I just didn't really see anything from this guy that I thought to myself, oh, he's really going to destroy me. So get some good blocking. This is the best run of the game. With the inside zone, he actually misses a couple of tackles right there. I come back to some crossers, and actually I'm able to go and hit him in the seam. He actually comes down and plays a crossing route underneath, and I'm able to go and tack him up top. So basically get down 10-0 against my opponent. He goes with the mesh concept, and I actually get a nice little black shed sack with Aaron Donald. No huddles out of this tight formation. And right here, I actually jump into just a man blitz out of the nickel blitz. His offensive line does not pick it up. I'm able to go ahead and get him down on a 3-yard line. Then I send the dogs after him, basically send 7. Double heat pressure comes after him and actually safeties him and puts him down and gives me a safety and gets me the ball right back there. So I try to go ahead and motion out my guy right here. I'm looking deep. I've got this guy set up for a cover 3 beater, but I go ahead and drop it down, and the running back does not come up with it. Try a little crossing route on the back inside. Wide receiver does not come with it, come down with it. Throwing in some coverage. And right here, I'm going with a nice little money play. I'm able to go ahead and hit him in the seam. The defender does not play that correctly. There's only one way to shut that play down consistently, and it's running a cloud coverage with your safety. So I take a nice little draw play up the middle, come back to this money play that is for money plays for my Patreon right there. Get him down to the 7-yard line. Now, this is a play you will see in my channel be broken down. It is a money play that you can actually use down in the red zone to get some touchdowns. I go for the 2-point conversion, try to change up the play a little bit. Not able to convert. So down 15-7. I'm getting the ball here in the second half, and look at this. He gets a perfect animation by his defensive back, and he's able to go ahead and intercept the out route that I was abusing him pretty much all day with. So that actually changes up my reads in the future on how I'm going to go and read this. He takes off this quarterback, and I think he tries to throw off. Fortunately for me, he does not catch it in bounds because Breeze is able to get away with it. So I've got man coverage right here. And he didn't really have good plays set up for this because he had two crossing guys going over the middle of the field, and they're basically the same depth. I don't understand the setup of that play. Right here, I get a blitz, a sack, and also get a turnover, but I'm offsides with Clay Matthews, so it resets the play once again. So 3rd and 5, I'm going to set him up with the pressure. I discovered fairly quickly that this guy really does not have good pass protections. He doesn't block enough, so I'm just going to keep sending the dogs after him, and he throws right to Clay Matthews. Matthews is able to go and swap the ball out right there and get the ball back to me. So try a little pitch play. Running game was not really working against this guy's defense. He was able to go and shut me down. Come back to another play. I'm able to go and hit this seam route. This is a great money play that I put together for one of my patrons. I really like it a lot. You can definitely abuse your opponent with it. Go back to the stretch. Finally get some fairly good blocking. Able to go ahead and pick up some pretty good yards. Come back to another play right here. Basically shut down, so I'm going to go ahead and take off my quarterback, pick up yards, get a first down. So that was the right read. Back to the out on the other side, because that Lattimore on the left side was picking me off. I'm going to go to the right side with that little out. Go back to the option play. Just doesn't work for me. Does it? You know, on paper you think it's going to work, and it doesn't. It doesn't work in gameplay. So that's one of the reasons why you always want to get online ranked to see if you can really master your scheme. Drop it down underneath. Try to go ahead and do a nice little dive with an inside zone. Unable to get that in. Try it again with a pass out of the same formation. He's able to get pressure. And I come back to this nice little money play down to the red zone. 3rd and 13 situation. I go ahead and throw it, catch the ball in, but I have a penalty against the offense for holding because I had aggressive blocking on. So I take that off, able to go and hit the seam and actually get the ball into the end zone, going up 22 points against his first 17. So 22 unanswered points to put him in a bind right there. So it's a little crosser right there. And no huddles. This is this guy's scheme. He would always no huddle. Even though he had plenty of time, he didn't need to no huddle in this type of situation. He didn't want the pressure off the edge because he's only got 5 people. He doesn't have a 6 blocker to take on the pressure, and he just wasn't really adjusting. Once I started hitting this guy with a lot of pressure, he didn't really have an answer. So once again, more pressure coming off the edge right there. He does not make a fast read with that, and it's a 4th and 17 situation. I go out of the double A gap. Really good blitz. Pressure comes off both sides. I'm able to go and pick it up. He actually did block a guy, but because of the way the pressure was set up, I was able to go get a big play right there. So right here, go ahead, milking the clock right now. I'm getting it down inside the 2-minute warning, and I just want to go and milk as much clock as possible from this guy. And I'll go up 8 points, put the major pressure on him, try to burn some of his timeouts too while I'm at it. So right here, working the clock, I actually go ahead and hit the seam, get the ball into the end zone in a situation like that, and go up by 2 scores against my opponent. And that's it. He basically checked out. So once again, to my subscribers, thank you for your support. To my patrons, thank you for your support. And I'll be rolling out more gameplay and tips and schemes to help you take your game to the next level. So thanks a lot. Until next time.